Hey everyone, Shawn Clement here, Wisdom in Golf and instructor for Golf Channel Academy. Today, really important stuff for you. You know, we've talked a lot about, do we bow the wrists? Do we hinge the wrists? Do we cup the wrists? What's good, what's not for you? Really important, right? So some of you have no issues bowing the wrists at the top of the backswing. That's going to affect the kind of grip that you're going to have. So you need to be able to match your grip to the kind of wrist action in your golf swing. Stay tuned. But before we continue, please, you know, consider subscribing to our channel and leave us a comment or question down below that we'll be more than happy to go check out and answer for you. And ring that notification bell so you don't miss another one of our fabulous videos here at Wisdom in Golf. Oh yeah, and give us a like. Now, many of you have been instructed to have a neutral grip and a square club face. And for many of you, that will simply not do. There's no way my daughter Sav could do that, or Zach Johnson, or Brendan Steele, or Webb Simpson, or 100 other players on the PGA Tour. So if you're struggling with a neutral grip and a square face, and the ball keeps going off to the right if you're a right-handed player, well, you need a different option. And we got two other options for you. So the first thing that we would like for you to do is let go of the club, turn it in about 45 degrees, and re-grip it. So this is me closing the face. Notice how my hands aren't moving, right? And this is me opening the face with the same grip. So we close the face. Now you've got options. You can either come back and expose all four knuckles of that lead hand the way Sav does, the way Charlie Woods has it. You notice Charlie Woods, in the latest analysis that we did, had a very, very strong grip. Now it's just a very strong grip. And at the top of the backswing, if we look at that, for me, I have a strong grip. And at the top of the backswing, my wrists are hinging on the anatomical snuff boxes. Now, for many of you, you think this is a cupped wrist. It is not. It is a hinged wrist. So notice the back of both hands are hinging together and they're actually facing each other. This would be cupped. Notice the difference? A cupped back of the left hand is a collapsed back of the left hand. Notice how my right wrist is in a bowed position as the left wrist is cupped. So that's going to add a lot of loft to the club. So notice what that does to your grip. And if I bow at the top with my left, I'm actually cupping with the right. See how that works? That's going to shut the club face down and make it point toward the sky. Very much like you see Dustin Johnson or Brooks Koepka. So what Sav does, and what a lot of the strong grippers do, is they have a beautifully strong grip, and at the top of the backswing, they have a very neutral way of hinging the wrists, and they've got a strong or a slightly square to closed look on that club face. And this is extremely important for you to get through the golf ball. If you look at hockey, why does a hockey stick have a big curved blade on it? That's because every instrument known to humanity, apart from a push broom, is designed to have the hands forward. So as soon as my hands move forward, then you'll notice that the club face opens up. Look at if you want a good baseball acid test, hold your club right out in front of you, close it 45 degrees, wait for the pitch. Now, notice as I'm waiting for the pitch, my wrists are nicely hinged. Now we're going out into the field. Look at my club face now. That's far from being closed, isn't it? It's only dynamically square now, okay? So your goal is to deliver your shot into the picture and see how the ball flies. If the ball consistently starts to the right and fades to the right, your grip club relationship isn't strong enough, or you've got some sort of collapsing going on during the swing that's preventing you from delivering properly to the golf, you know, to the target. So a good way to see how that wrist is supposed to hinge, imagine you're going fishing. So just allow that wrist to hinge on that snuff box. Notice how it's hinging. I would never go fishing like this. That's really going to hurt. You need the support of the other hand to be able to do that. So when I'm going fishing, this is the most anatomically sound way of doing it. If you look at tennis, when a tennis player is getting ready for a serve, they're hinging on that anatomical snuff box. That's a biggie. And when you're playing baseball, same thing. You're preloaded on those snuff boxes. You're not preloading a bow in your wrist. That's really going to hurt when you're trying to hit a baseball with that. So I don't recommend that for everyone. But if you've been doing it since you're yay high, like Colin Morikawa or Graham McDowell or Dustin Johnson, we don't want to change that. You're already slinging it out there. So all we need to do is just tweak your grip club relationship and allow you to continue swinging out towards the target. So here's a good way of doing it. How do you put the ball, because many of you are so concerned about the golf ball, how do we put the ball in the way of you swinging toward the target? Well, go look at our throwing the club video. So if I had to throw a golf club, I got a curtain right here. Notice how I'm throwing the club into that curtain. See how everything is moving out of the way? My brain is locked in on that curtain. I go to the ground, use the ground to get my body out of the way. I don't have to think about that. I'm just looking for hitting that curtain with my golf club. So if you do that and you don't let go, so if I were to throw this club towards you, throw, notice now, if I don't let go of the club, the weight of the club is going to release my anatomy. And so when I'm going deep out toward the target, the weight of the club is going to release me. You watch Tiger, he's got one of the best releases in the business. That's why you want to definitely look at him. Another one that's got a very similar release to Tiger is Bryson DeChambeau. So the weaker the grip, the more pronounced the release is going to be. And the stronger the grip, the more pronounced the body turn is going to be. If you look at Charlie Woods right here last year, before he made the modification to a slightly less strong grip this year, you'll notice that he was having to spin out of his shoes in order to get to his targets. Now he can really stay with a proper follow-through. And that's why you'll see Savannah with this unbelievable extension towards the target, because this is what allows her to stay out there much deeper. So which one's best for you? Well, the way you try it out is you put your hands on the club, and let's go with a Goldilocks version. So I'm going to open up the club face. I'm going to throw my club in the direction of the target. If I throw, it feels like the ball's going to go way off to the right. Let's see how much. Throw. Well, there you go. Right into the tree on the right. Sound familiar? And if I close the face too much, and many of you, right, I have you close the face like this in my lesson, and you have the choice now. You can square it up if you want, make that strong grip. It's going to feel like there's a lot more tension in that lead arm. Or you can just let it relax and be somewhere in between. And we're going to throw the club into the picture. Here we go. So we throw it, and now we look at the hook on that sucker, and not good either. So we look at that. It's a pretty long 7-iron right there. But look at my side spin is 1500 RPM. So if I do something in between, right? For me, it's a strong grip, a three knuckle grip with square face. And now I'm just going to throw the club in the direction I want to start the ball again, and let's see what happens. So now I get the center of the fairway and slight draw. See that? Little straight axis right there. I got 350 RPM to the right, or to the left, I should say. And, you know, even though my shot started a little bit more to the right, that was the proper grip club relationship that I needed for a small draw, because I was looking for a draw. And so once you've got a pattern, so you say, all right, neutral grip, square face, and the ball is moving like what just happened there, then you're fine. If you feel like it's not coming back, keep closing the face until you see a pattern that's coming back. First, foremost, that the most important priority for you is to see the ball curving back to the left. So use Goldilocks to go to the extremes, see what happens. And then once you've got that face closed enough, then you won't have to worry about bowing that wrist at the top of the backswing. Because, I mean, why would you have to think about squaring up over here? That would prevent you from going to the target, wouldn't it? So when you're looking down at the ball, you got to be thinking where you're headed with that golf ball. And then when you deliver it in that direction, you just want to feel that the ball's going to go in that direction. So enjoy that, and we'll see you in the next one.